Hi, Peter. Before you go home today, I need to show you how to give yourself the heparin injections you've been having in hospital.
Oh. Why do I have to keep having them?
You've been having the injections in hospital to prevent you from developing blood clots in your veins while you've been unable to move around much. You'll need to continue the injections after discharge until you return to hospital for a surgical review in a couple of weeks.
Okay. Are you saying that I have to give myself the injections now?
You can give yourself the injections, or someone at home can give them.
Well, I live on my own, so I guess I'll have to do it. I'm not sure I can manage it though.
The idea of giving yourself an injection is a bit daunting at first, I know. I'll explain how to do it now. And you can see if you feel more comfortable about it then. Okay?
I suppose. If it's important for me to keep having them.
Yes, it is very important. The first thing to know is that the injections are already for you. Each injection has the correct dose in it. The needle is already attached to the syringe as well. Here is one in its packet for you to look at.
Okay, I see. It's got an air bubble in it. Do I have to get rid of that? You often see nurses doing that on TV shows, before they give an injection, don't you?
Yes, that's right. We do remove air bubbles in a syringe before giving an injection, but these injections are different. The air bubble is supposed to stay in the syringe. Don't worry, it's not harmful at all.
That's good to know. So, what do I have to do?
The first thing to do is to get everything ready. Wash your hands well with soap and water. Select an area in your abdomen. Pick a different area each day. It's important not to inject near any bruising or scars. And avoid a 5 cm area around your belly button as well.
Right.
Take a syringe out of the packet. And double check that it's the correct dose. You'll be having 2,500 units each day. Here it is on the syringe.
2,500 units. Okay. I see. How do I hold the syringe?
Just hold the syringe as if it were a pen. And you're about to do some writing.
I'm left-handed. Do I have to hold the syringe in my right hand?
No, hold the syringe in whichever hand you feel more comfortable with. In your case, it will be your left hand.
That's good. I don't think I could do it using my right hand.
Now, using your forefinger and thumb on your other hand, pinch a fold of skin around the area you're going to inject into. Can you show me how you do that?
Sure. I'll use my right hand to do this. I'd pinch the skin to the left of my belly button like this.
Yes. That's how to do it.
That seems to be the easy part. What about the injection itself?
Keep holding the fold of skin as you gently push the needle in. You are going to insert the needle at a 90-degree angle.
You mean, straight in, not at an angle?
That's right. As you can see, the needle itself is very small. And it's also quite fine. Just push it into the skin, gently but firmly.
Okay, what then?
Slowly push the plunger at the end of the syringe in to empty the syringe. It should take between 10 and 20 seconds to do that. Remember to keep holding the fold of skin.
Okay, how do I get the needle out?
Just slowly remove the needle at the same 90-degree angle. Then you can let go of the skin fold. After you take out the needle, don't rub your skin as this can cause bruising.
I understand. What do I do with the used syringes?
You'll have a small sharp spin to take home with you. Like the one on the wall over there. Place the used syringe and needle into the bin, after you've give yourself the injection. Don't try to take off the needle at all. Just put the whole unit in the bin.
Okay, I'll do that.
Right. Now you've learned how to give yourself your heparin injection. I'll watch you giving this morning's injection yourself. I have everything here with me now. How do you feel about that?
A bit nervous. But happy you'll watch me the first time.